Hi everybody, thanks again for joining us here on Geektech Industries and the Game Nexus. We're down here at Triple Play, doing our recording of our matches, of course. Brought Ray with me again today. So we should have an interesting match tonight. Ray, why don't you tell us what you brought?
I call it my Hulk Smash build. Basically, it's one of the highest, what I thought would be the highest hit points that you can put on the field.
Okay.
And still be viable. And I have two ghosts and a Y-Wing.
Ooh, okay. So,
that's 40 hit points.
So, of course, we'll have the list for that down in the diddly-doo below. So if you want to see what that that is all about, definitely go and check that out. I myself am bringing a list. I've never flown. I talked about it in Theorycraft on Thursday. I brought a list focused around the Lancer Pursuit Craft using Asajj Ventress, paired up with Kavil and a Jumpmaster Contracted Scout. So we'll see how this is going to go. Honestly, I'm a little afraid. I'm pretty sure that he's just going to tear me open.
They're just Autoblaster Turrets. Nothing to be afraid of.
I know, but all of my stuff sort of looks at reducing your defense dice. And if you got no defense dice, I can't reduce it. So.
Zero is zero.
Yeah, exactly. So we'll see how that's going to go. Oh, man, I'm so terrified. All right, so we will see you guys on the map. Here we are at the mat. As you can see, we've determined initiative, rated the roll-off, and he won the roll-off. So he chose to chose initiative in this case, so he's going to definitely move first. So we've placed our debris, we've placed our ships and set our maneuvers, and I think we are ready to roll. I'm just going to start the timer.
I am ready to roll. And by virtue of super low pilot skills, my initiative won't matter a whole hell of a lot. So we're going one... It forces you to adapt up, but it doesn't really matter because it's a free card.
Yeah, I love adaptability for that. It's so flexible.
Everybody's slow boating here. We're going to see what you're going to do first here.
Oh my god. So you're like, hold on, I need to respond to you. Yep. And yeah, I have a feeling it's going to be something similar.
I didn't want to run into the part of the dragon's mouth just yet.
Well, it's not exactly a dragon. It's more of a large lizard.
Yeah.
So, okay, so lowest on my stack is the jump master. So, oh, there you go, dear.
That was, oh, okay. Sorry, I thought you put the bait tokens in.
Yes, I have an eight tokens.
So I hit the crit.
Sorry about all the background noise, folks.
So
it's really busy here today. So, all right, we have the contracted scout at four. He's gonna move forward one.
Everybody's in scouting mode.
But I'm good.
Slow boats ahoy! Here we go. Next up would be Asajj Ventress. She's also going to forward one.
That's not even a green.
No.
Oh my god.
No, all of her, she's similar to a defender in that all of her green maneuvers are on the low, or sorry, on the high parts of her dial.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. All of my threes are green.
Wow.
So, and then good old Kavil, he's forward one as well.
That is obstructed. No, you get two, and then obstructed.
They're all gonna focus up.
And then we're gonna sweep and go back to dice.
And then we sweep tokens. And sets of maneuvers.
Back in the saddle again.
So that's it. You take a shield. Nobody else can attack. We're all done. Sweep your tokens.
I acquired the target lock, then he moved. And now is in range.
Yep.
First shot, stripped all the shields off the party bus, and same thing. Flew behind, dropped the mines, blew them up. And it was just like each ship only dug two volleys together. Like, well, that's exactly what I built for.
Yeah, God, so many freaking hit points. This is going to be so hard for me.
I brought four bombers to regionals.
Mm-hmm. Now, which one of these is the one with Zeb? This one, isn't it?
Zeb is Y.
Zeb is double Y? Okay.
Zeb is double Y.
Okay. Double strikes are so powerful that they're able to augment
scary hat. Hey, Mike. Ah, he did show up.
Woo-hoo.
Okay, we're set. Reveal your maneuver, sir.
Reveal? What? Who knows that I had to do that?
Oh, you got one working?
Well, we'll see. We'll see. This is my first time flying it, so.
So we're going 3-4.
We chose to go with Ventress this time.
Have you guys seen the new Errata? Yeah.
That would have changed yesterday's fight, by the way. Sunday's fight. Just saying.
Yeah, Deadeye now. Saying. Small ship only.
What? I want a rematch.
Yeah. Killed the contracted
also,
scout meta.
Also, just so you know, the back arcs can only do torpedoes.
Yes.
Unless you have the Phantom in it.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. We discussed that actually. That was.
But he's got autoblaster turrets on him, so it's smooth.
Still good.
Do you see the Biggs now?
Yeah, Biggs, so...
And the Heavy Psych title.
Yeah, the Heavy Psych is what got me so pumped about the Heavy Psych. Oh, man.
So, does anyone have double Manaroo bases? I got swapped with someone. Look.
I got double Lebos, yeah. Sorry.
I don't actually have the base I need. I saw I ended up with swapping a base with someone.
No.
Yeah, this
I'll look at one to see if I got three.
Yeah, I knew that afterwards.
Yeah.
Like,
because
I
have two
points, Scott.
So I'll have two for sure.
But I guess it didn't matter. Anyways,
so
I don't think I ever really
one,
used it.
So
you done
one.
Your maneuvers?
I only have one jump.
Bio auto turret, though.
Oh!
I have no one.
So which one are you missing, though?
No, I was right in your face.
Oh, you're missing the
I think I made a mistake.
I'll take a look at how
was it?
Seriously doubt it, though. I don't think I've even flown against you.
I don't remember that. I think I made a mistake.
No, it's okay.
That's okay. So done
I
didn't know either until you've done your maneuvers. Have you done your actions?
Okay, so which, what dials are what?
This one's...
Set them next to the ships, buddy.
That's
a lot of dash.
I think I suspect rather than me ending up having.
Oh, he's
going to
attempt
a
target lock.
Obviously,
it's not going to happen.
The Countess,
not this time. Not this time.
He's going to take a focus.
Okay. So I'm going to do the lowest one of mine is the contracted scout. He's going to move forward 4.
Oh.
5 in the face.
Hey, Mike, did you bring your down master?
Maybe.
Yeah, I did. Do you need something?
Maybe.
Did I use your Mataru base?
Mataru base?
I probably swapped this with Paul at some point. I think that's who it was.
And then his action is going to be to acquire a target lock. So I've got my eyes on double Y there with Zeb.
Double Zeb?
Yeah.
Zeb.
Bump.
Make sure I know
this guy. Bump, no action.
Ventress.
We can just go like this.
So Ventress is going to forward 5.
Come on.
Yeah, we have this guy. This guy is so good. Well, they might not realize because...
No action. And then my
he's
next.
He's an ally.
And then... I will take my action to rotate my arc to the left side.
Okay.
Right.
Does that become your primary?
No. You have a primary arc still in the front. You have a secondary arc that you can rotate between the other three.
Yeah. Okay.
And then Cavil, going to do a forward 3.
And he'll just focus.
And then he will attempt
your
to
two
take
eights.
A target lock.
Two
I think
eights.
That's too far away.
No chance.
Oh, no. Nope, you're right. Just out.
Oops. Well, 2's a bump. That
and
one
so he will
fly
focus.
Right
are you flying your super?
No, I'm not. Trying out my the modify.
There we go.
Oh.
Okay.
Bombs away.
At the start of the combat phase,
it's not going to fit.
I may choose a ship at range 1 to 2. That one. If it is inside my mobile firing arc, which it is,
okay,
I assign a stress token
action?
To it.
What's his action?
Sure.
Since he's the only one who gets an action, he's
going to
get an
action.
Okay.
Oh,
man, there's a lot of
stuff. So, Cavil doesn't have a shot. He's out of range. So, Ventress. I'm going to... Attempt to attack that ship. It looks like it's range 2. That's good.
What else they should throw into the
FAQ? Okay, so I'm going to 3 dice from my primary.
Yeah. But I was thinking more so like, you know, like when you get like
the so this one, three dice from the primary.
Okay. Like, well, in this case, it's out of my secondary arc here, but it's my primary weapon.
Find it, like, it's a big way you can include that in your regular game.
After you perform an attack that hits with the Shadowcaster title, I get to assign a tractor beam token to that ship.
Is the biggest
to make ship,
stat.
I can't move
nothing,
it, I can't release
nothing
dice.
Nothing in the because Wingman ain't going to trigger for anything.
Good! Damn it! Now my...
Put the balance of obstacles.
I should have actually. No, actually, this will work. Because that is range two. Good. So, Jumpmaster is going to use his target lock to fire his Flechette Torpedo.
I'll take it. Range two at air. I will choose.
Only
because it's primary.
Level.
I get one extra dice.
So, here comes three dice.
So, it's range two.
Yeah, my whole set on a 4.
Actually, can I take that back? I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's a play game. It's, there's no $10,000 prize at the end.
Okay,
man.
Good. I realized I want
hits.
To save that until later.
Two hits.
Yep. So just primary, two dice.
So one hit.
So one crit.
Lose another shield.
Okay, and then your ship's getting to shoot.
All right. So
neither of
four
your
and four.
Have a shot.
We're gonna just four in the face,
this
four in the face.
Okay.
I have more 7 dice.
Yeah, I know, but my this guy's an 8.
Right.
Oh.
Wait, you can turn on
the
top,
dude. Yeah, these little guys
actually
have
rear fire. So we're going to...
On wait, which one? This guy first, I'm assuming?
Yeah. So I'm going to spend his focus and I'm going to make those both hits.
Two hits,
so,
okay.
Aaron's definitely in our...
And then immediately after shooting, he gets a target lock. A free target lock. Okay. Oops. Oh, you took fire control system?
Yep.
Nice.
Range two.
Okay, and my defense is two of eight! Keep at it, buddy. Keep at it.
Through debris.
Use those up early in the game, apparently.
So I'm shooting
and then
for
this
my
is
arc.
Double O.
Yep,
yeah,
double O.
Whoa, two crits?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah, okay. It doesn't matter. It's nothing. You still got shields.
Two.
Now that is range two.
But it is
right?
Extra range two. So you will get an extra dice.
Yeah.
Oh!
And, oh, horrible.
Nothing.
All right, finally.
Nothing. So two
wheels
down on the.
I will use
Jump
my
Master.
Accuracy corrector, cancel all my dice.
And then the Y Wing is way out of range.
Y Wing is way out of range.
Okay.
And he
you
also
know
gets a.
That was a good trade.
He also gets a free target lock.
Oh, wow. Picking up,
one of
picking up
so
some target locks there, Scout.
Oh.
Okay.
It's just a hit. Yeah.
Okay. So now we sweep
okay.
tokens.
And then.
Sweep tokens.
Don't we?
He shoots.
I guess I got nothing.
So you got no tokens to sweep.
I didn't even
your Y Wing.
No, they all had focuses. Everybody.
I know. They. The, well,
I never
that guy used them, but these guys didn't. So.
Oh yeah.
He's gonna shoot her.
Never.
Doesn't matter what range.
Yeah, because
it's a second level weapon.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay. So straight up. Oh, nice! You get to turn one hit to a crit. So it's hit and a crit.
You might have got focus tokens.
I see the problem with Flechette Torpedoes now.
And
they're going to be totally useless against this build.
Yep. Well, they still do damage.
I will actually...
Yeah, but I'm looking at the stress accumulation on them.
An
so.
Evade result, a focus
like on,
result, and a blank.
What's her name? Narrow Dantles?
I won't spend my focus token. I'll spend my evade token.
Twice.
So that's good enough.
It doesn't matter that it stresses or not.
So
you
haven't
taken any
damage.
Just
no,
playing.
I think you're going to win.
We have almost as many people playing here.
and then the Countess gets to shoot.
I didn't feel like spending 10
So I'm pretty sure he is.
Where you got
my heart? No outlet somewhere.
Yeah, so there's outlets
right
over there. Or
well, this is
here. Yeah, there's like four plugs here.
Don't think.
Is there more plugs right over there?
There's four plugs here.
Oh, okay.
So it's range two.
I'm only taking up one.
Unobstructed. So the Countess shoots three dice.
Well, sweet dice tower.
I know,
two.
Right? Some awesome dude gave me that.
And two hits.
Yeah.
Two hits. You get two dice. Two of big.
He's too nice. What are you saying?
Those
are two
nice.
Okay.
Trust me, I know what people
That's it.
Nice
sweep tokens.
Sweep.
Okay.
Five ships.
Oh,
the
interceptor,
right?
They're in your box.
Huh. Oh,
well,
with
I'm
the slicer tools?
I'm already with three
yeah.
Yeah.
I love how the slicer tools is actually
all
Zuckus.
The advanced targeting
like, the picture is Zuckus. I love it.
Now I'm good to go.
Okay. You ready?
Yep.
Let's do it.
Leader,
I mean, not like that. You're gonna kill me.
Calls it is at the start of the end phase. You can spend a target lock you have on an enemy ship and put one random boost on down.
Ah, crap. That's fine.
Phase up.
You're pretty much bang on where you were gonna be anyway, so.
And
and the other guy is getting cranked or something.
Commander Allison. He can acquire a target lock at the start of the combat phase on an enemy.
Whatever you can get for that, I don't care.
One. They all have the command target here.
No, Calzette does not have that. He has an active director. Is the advanced target computer?
Overlap?
Oh my god.
Yep, overlap on the thing. No, I don't think you bump.
I don't bump.
Hold on. Just. Here, I'll hold him. And just go ahead and.
I'm going to move this guy first. I got the choice, right?
Yes, technically, yes.
Okay. But you still spend it for that round. Yeah.
Okay.
But then again, this guy wants to save.
Let's get some traffic in the way here.
Those are $4, and these ones are $3.
There you go.
Okay, so bump.
So I got Mana Roo.
Yeah, I know, right? It's like got the worst.
Yeah, that's pretty much the whole tournament I spent with it off.
So
between the pipes.
Get him between the back pips there. Oh, your overlap.
You
overlap the asteroid. You just bumped it.
Did I?
Yeah, you did. Okay, you shifted it like 2 millimeters. Okay. There we go. Okay, and then so he did he do a green?
Yeah.
So he shed his stress, and he got rid of that last turn. So all he's got is double eyes.
Dang, I didn't think I was gonna hit that.
Okay.
Your stress token. And then this guy just simply, here, I'll hold that.
Hold on.
Hold the end. There you go. Worst stand ever.
During modified attack dice.
And then, yeah, he's about there.
He just takes
collide. There you go. Pull it out.
Pull it out.
Okay, so.
And neither of them get actions, eh?
Count
no, that's horrible.
It's really good.
I thought at least I knew one person wouldn't, and I wasn't too worried about that.
You forgot about the size of your base, didn't you?
No, I just actually didn't think. I thought I would actually clear that asteroid.
Okay.
Yeah.
So Kavil is. We do a forward one, which
because
I was expecting you to be in a totally different place.
Yeah. So was I.
Kavil is, however, going to acquire a target lock on this local rebel here. So Kavil takes his double Ks.
Your seven.
Double Ks.
There
you go. Oh wait, I did that bad. Totally did that wrong. I'm so sorry. He moves last, doesn't he?
Is the end result the same?
Maybe. Maybe. I'm so sorry about that.
Good.
Okay. Oh, look, I telegraphed him. Contract is scout. K turn 4.
Dad!
Okay.
You just
I did vote by a millimeter.
Okay,
yeah.
So your action.
So if you would be so kind.
Hold that.
There. Perfect.
No.
He ends up.
My 8 goes first.
And this way.
Oh, you're gonna push the limit?
Okay. There we go. What's that double O?
I'm gonna take a.
Oh, he had the double O.
Yeah,
that's
the double
right.
O.
Okay.
Eyes.
So I'll take a stress.
And then a double Y from him. Okay, good. He now has a stress token. Boop.
Okay.
Ventress.
It's
gonna do a forward
I'm
three.
Take a stress because we're going over debris, but I don't care.
Still in my side arc, so I'm gonna leave my arc the way it is. And she will take.
He ignores.
Cavils
forward. He pretty much ignores debris. If he lands on an asteroid, if he parks on an asteroid, he can't shoot. So you're eight.
Take. I'm gonna acquire a target lock on that local rebel after all.
Roger that.
Okay.
There we go.
Okay.
Okay. So. He doesn't get to attack.
What's his
at
action?
All. That's awesome.
You guys shoot first. Yep.
So Kavil, no shot. Ventress, I think is range 2.
take an inch.
That range two in my secondary arc, so three dice again.
Yep.
I'll take an inch.
Oh, sorry, at the start of combat, I give you a stress with Ventress' ability.
Oh
and,
my god, three hits.
Two hits and a crit.
Wow.
And
that's a nice roll.
His action.
That's good rolling on that one. Good rolling.
Yeah.
And then I guess last but not least is a contracted scout. Gonna feed three dice into that Lothal Rebel there.
Yep.
Oh no! Oh, I'll do it. I'll use my double eye. Alright. Use my target lock. Reroll all three of these.
Oh, I'm glad you didn't have a focus.
Oh, are you kidding me? Two focuses and a hit. Okay.
Yeah, he'll focus.
Same one, right?
Still haven't shed his shields yet, eh?
Okay.
One left.
All right. And that's that for him.
My turn to shoot.
Who has
your turn to shoot?
Andrew goes first.
Range
so
one. He can't shoot because
the
bomb's
on
the rock,
right?
So he's going to use his autoblaster turret. However,
it doesn't
matter. It's obstructed, though, so.
Is it?
No, he'll be brought
up. If I hit you, have no defense anyways.
Well, if you roll straight hits, yes.
Might as well.
So,
I'm
still going to get an extra die.
Hold
on.
I'm going to spend my focus.
Seal it.
Just pour out one more.
Seal it. Mm-hmm. Autoblaster turret, turret weapons can still be obstructed, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Secondary weapons are still obstructed.
So, okay, I just don't get my range. Okay, so
yeah,
two hits.
No range bonuses, but
matter,
still
can't evade,
so. So two hits, boom, boom, two shields down.
Okay, so
right
beginning of combat.
That's it.
My nine.
That's it.
Wow, that's a very disastrous round for me.
Range two.
Yeah.
Could be worse. Could be worse.
Ooh,
very much could be worse.
He'll take his.
Okay, so I guess we sweep
he
tokens.
Three
just
dice
this one.
The front.
Yep.
How many FOs do you have? I have four now. So I have one expansion, two for the base, and then I've got.
So
I think that's all I've extra FOs and normal types.
And this is against him, so. And then
I've got five FOs, so
I'll spend the focus.
I wouldn't mind trading one. I want four to put
so that's
on.
Two hits and a crit.
Yeah. That,
you get two dice.
I mean, some of them just looking like, whatever.
So you take
I'll enjoy
a hit and a crit.
Take a crit and you die.
So a hit.
Hit.
Like I can't
and
fit four defenders.
And that was a thrust control fire immediately. Receive one thrust on him.
Doesn't matter, he's dead.
Whoop.
Okay, I'll take this focus.
So that. Specifically with, like,
that was my
list.
Nine.
I will
four,
put
eight.
All
my
of
eight is next.
Their leader, their ace,
so
their regular pilots, their specialists.
Whoa! Yeah, the low parts of my dial here.
I got like nothing.
Shot.
on. But it all the
dash.
And that is the front firing arc, and he's not shooting from the back. He gets an extra dice. Three dice. Yeah, special ops training gives me three dice. When I'm shooting up front. If I choose not to shoot on that. Okay, so
with the flechette?
Three dice, straight up. On.
I'm already thinking about modifying this build to replace Kavil with Sarasu with flechette.
Okay,
and
you got one focus result, you might as well
if
spend it.
Don't
so you
face against
shield.
Huge ships.
Take
a shield.
See, that's what's with my.
Take shield off.
Build. It's awesome against little ships, but as soon as I'm up against large ship,
balls
no
right.
Okay.
Okay! Oh, you only
have
one more.
Yes, Ed Hunters.
Your eight has no shot.
And a.
Come check this game out.
Your eight has no shot.
Oh, yeah.
So that means dash. Dash shoots. Who's
he
shooting at?
Hurt.
Okay.
He gets three dice.
Three dice.
What's up?
With a focus. And
target.
Okay.
Nice.
Focus that
oh,
up.
Yeah.
Focus.
Yeah. I'm good. So, first,
okay,
you ready?
Yeah.
Bring it. Bring it.
What you
bring
should
it.
Do before spending your focus. So
see,
keep that
list,
focus up.
I wanted to
keep
play.
Your focus on the table.
I didn't. Don't even.
Okay. Re-roll your dice first down. Before. No, no.
So
don't re-roll the focus. Don't re-roll focus.
This
just keep that on the table.
Yeah.
Okay, now spend your focus. Because if you had rolled a focus result, then you would have been able to flip both of them.
Well, you focus
okay,
that one
go.
Up into a hit,
like
and then or, the other one becomes a crit from the mangler.
Yeah, because mangler.
Yeah.
Mangler.
Yeah.
So he's doing a green two.
So hit a crit on
you want this guy?
Yeah. Under the cannon.
Okay.
big focus.
Three dice.
Can you find the peanut there?
That's it.
Nubbin snake.
And she'll spend the focus. Actually, she won't. She won't spend the focus. She'll spend her evade token, and she's done.
And she still has a target lock, so he
Wait, first of all, I need to check my
idea. Yeah, you're way off.
Yeah, he's like, wee.
Yeah, you're still packing that.
Okay, so the Countess has a shot.
On him.
He'll evade, and he's going to go at 92.
Range one. So she will get four dice.
That's a collision, isn't it?
I get one.
Oh, such a collision.
You get two.
Is it?
Yeah. I do have a focus.
You'd probably actually be
in Let me just put a straight one in there. We'll see
three.
Just exactly where he ends up.
Going as fast as you can go.
There you go. Okay. And you got it there.
And that's it.
Okay. Oops. That's good enough. Okay, I'll hold the rebel. You pull the die.
Both of these countries, I think, are
part of
the
lock.
Okay.
Two out of there, you can eat it.
Two dials.
Oh, no, I shared that away.
Okay. So, bottom of my stack, that's your two bank. Bottom of my stack is this guy's going to do a forward one, which collides straight in. He doesn't shed his token. Gets no action. Or, sorry, it's a green maneuver, so he sheds his stress, doesn't get an action. Okay, and then Ventress is going to do a turn two. You'd be so kind, sir.
I most certainly will.
And then...
I love the action.
Our action will be to take a focus. And then, last but not least, Kavil is going to do a turn three. Because he has Unhinged Astromech, that is a green maneuver.
You can only fire back when you lose your shield in an attack.
He will reacquire his target lock. Yeah,
thanks for jumping into his arc.
And then,
okay, finally, Kavil gets into the fray. Yeah. So, I have
and she will
range
focus.
One. Range one. Yep. I will Autoblaster. Yep.
Wow.
Two hits, straight up, done. At the start of the combat phase, I keep forgetting about this. I can't forget. I'm not going to forget anymore. If I forget again, it's done. Ventress, arc.
Okay, and his action.
Now Ventress is going to attack, and I think it's range two.
This guy's dead, so it's basically
lost. Range two. Three dice on that dude. Wow. One hit.
Yeah, me too. I would have preferred an extra shield over a hull, but...
And then last but not least, I have a range 3 from the contracted scout there, or a range 2 obstructed.
I will...
Same shot, really.
Barrel
yeah, really,
roll.
It is. Technically.
That's why I'm up for trade.
Well, you could do.
Yeah, see, it's just over.
Yeah.
I'm going to take my range 3.
But I like that spell device too.
So,
much.
Two dice.
Large ships on the strike.
No. Not unless you got tactical gamma. So, one hit on that. Last shield on that guy.
No, I had
one way or another, but I had to roll. So,
oh yeah, that's right. Range 3, you get actually get a freaking.
That one made you do.
Well, it looks like there's a good one.
Okay, your turn.
Autoblaster.
Okay, on Kavil. Yep.
I do really want
or,
that
ball.
Yeah,
what's his evasion?
2.
Yeah. What, does he have any special
out of range, though, for the Autoblaster,
oh, yeah.
You can do 4 dice.
Oh, yeah, I can go 4 primary, but
I have 2
matter.
Defense dice and a focus.
What's his
that
action?
Bring, by the way. That would
you had me. You had me at Imperial.
Focus? Okay.
Yeah, you know what? We're gonna go with a 4 primary on your Shadowcaster.
Okay.
I hate splitting my shots up, but I got no choice this time.
Oh, my 9.
Hitting a crit.
Hitting a crit.
Okay.
Doing a 3 bank.
There you go.
And I get a...
Oh, and I'll use my focus to turn that into an evade, and I'll take 1 shield.
Okay. And I have chips.
And I get a target lock. I'm going to move my target lock.
Okay. Yep. So you move the double O. There you go. On to Ventress. Okay, and then your Y-Wing.
Y-Wing will take a range 3.
It's range 2 on your match.
Yeah, range 2.
Oh, my 9.
What the hell? It's free.
We'll get my 2 defense dice at least.
I'll focus it up for 1, just in case. You never know.
Yep. And there's my evade.
There's your evade.
He's got nothing.
And that was a.
Because that's torpedoes only.
Yeah.
And I'm out of range of your Autoblaster, so. Alright, let's carry on.
So, I will.
Does he have any focus? No, he doesn't.
Okay.
He has a focus.
Oh, boy.
Oh, you're not.
You know what? I will spend focus to guarantee I'm going to do damage then. So 3 hits. And so that's 2 hits. 2 more shields.
1 left.
Okay. That was 9 and then
8.
Go next.
Oh, no, there you go.
5 has initiative.
I just can't see with the glare.
And that's range 2. They'll get 3 dice. Straight up. And, 3 hits. Wow. And that's 3 hits.
I'm not
going
to waste that focus because it's just a waste of a focus.
I think you can pull that off.
My 8.
Your 8.
Dang it. I should have grabbed that.
I didn't like it when over at Curious and saw the tables in half, and I did not get them.
Yep,
the
you got arc on.
I want to shoot my iron pulse missiles, but I can't.
Some tables fit better than others, yeah.
Because I can't now, because I don't have a target on that.
So, just straight up shot then.
Straight
3
up.
Dice.
3 dice, though.
3 dice primary.
I don't know if any.
Not the Countess.
Nope.
And,
so much
nice.
Nope.
You do have a focus.
So much nope.
So, 2 hits and a crit on the Countess. So she gets 3 dice.
And Vader will.
It's too bad there isn't a Flechette turret.
So she'll send her arrows.
Oh, eventually. It'll come around eventually. It's just not here
cancel
yet.
Cancel the 2 hits.
So he'll move first.
Crit.
Yep.
So
one bang.
Takes a shield.
So Vader's the
one bang.
That's the first damage you did.
Well, I hope so too. The Flechette cannon's overcosted, in my opinion.
I'm not sure.
2 points.
Yeah,
and then the Countess should have Arcanine.
Exactly. It should cost
less. And then the card. So you don't need any of them.
Just at the back of blunt, so she 4 dice primary.
She's just gonna bump, stay right there. Exactly, take off the if it already has. So he just stays where he is.
3 hits.
Okay, cool.
I'm gonna tell you my
dad.
Oh man.
Guys are not
that's close height. That's gonna be tight like a twiga.
To get up to
a
couple inches from the edge of the
boat.
He's the double Y, isn't he?
That is.
Yeah, he's the
double
Y. He can actually go back on his post.
Look
at that. Look at that. There you go, buddy. We have a ghost back in play, everyone.
Yeah.
Okay. So now my go. He's gonna move forward 1, stays right where he is.
Okay.
Ventress is gonna attempt a bank 3.
That's awesome.
For some reason I didn't make the link, that's why.
Thank you, sir.
Or I put them on.
And then I'm going to keep my arc right there. And she will take a focus. And then last but not least, Kavil is going to do a bank 3. Oh, good. It doesn't overlap.
Nope.
It does not.
Cheap X.
A little bit more.
There we go. Nice. So I'm just gonna take a focus. Okay. Top of the stack. Cabell's gonna roll his 3 dice because if he's attacking out of arc, he gets extra dice.
All right.
So 3 dice autoblaster on your Y-wing there.
Okay.
Or which one's been hurt already? We could potentially strip the shields.
Everybody's
potentially strip shields.
Everybody's
still. I'm gonna kill the Y-wing.
Okay.
I think.
Yeah, I mean,
I'm okay with that. This guy likes.
Yeah, because I can focus the Y-wing down. Hopefully this turn.
Wow,
I'll use my focus to turn that into a hit. So two hits unavoidable, and you get to roll to avoid the crit.
I get to. I still get to avoid the crit.
You. Oh, it just adds an evade result. So whatever you roll. Plus.
Oh, I need to move my character over.
And nothing.
Nothing. So shields down.
Oh, good. So pass that off.
Ventress.
Six. You ready?
Has range 2.
So
oh, I forgot to trigger her start of combat.
Don't I get the don't I get this here for defense?
Not from Ventress.
No, from here?
You will against him, but Ventress is attacking first.
Who just hit me with the
Kavil?
Oh,
gotcha.
So Ventress, I forgot to use her at the start of combat. Assign a stress token.
Yes. Right. And you said you weren't going to do it.
I'm not going
to
do it. No, I have to suffer the pain, otherwise I won't remember. So three dice.
Nice.
And I'll focus that into two hits. Not an auto blaster, so you could potentially avoid one of those.
Yeah.
So that's from Ventress. Yeah.
Six dice.
So elevate it.
Okay, so you only take the one face down. And then last but not least.
And what's his option?
Closest to closest is obstructed. Range 2. So two dice.
Probably gonna take a charge.
No! Nothing. Don't even bother.
So I get two.
Okay. Well, I'm allowed to shoot back. Holy smacks. Okay, so we're just gonna double auto turret into this guy.
I hate that guy.
Two dice auto blaster turret. You can do a three dice primary if you wanted to.
Nope.
You're like, unavoidable damage is better.
Yep. And he's got a target lock, so.
Well, you had no choice.
Yeah, but he's got a target lock on that guy.
Well, no, you had no choice in what maneuver you had to do.
Why did I do?
Oh, you don't crash into the ground.
Okay. No, because he was over here.
Yeah, he was
until the end of the turn, basically.
Yeah, I thought I measured and I thought I got a target lock on him.
But you didn't place it on him, though.
Dang, you're right, I didn't. You're right, I didn't.
I don't know.
What's going on?
You're right, I didn't, so I have no idea to shoot on that guy because he's like in the mud.
There you go. There you go. Better?
Awesome, thanks. That's all good. I mean, I wasn't.
Hey, you've been good to me, so.
That goes down.
Oh,
yeah, I will roll that one. I will target lock that.
Damn it.
And still the same thing.
So one hit, unavoidable.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know what? You know what? I will.
Okay. Alright, and that's. Spent.
I can't do this with these guys, but it's
This guy.
No shot.
Oh, auto blaster, that's right. Two more, so that shields down on Kavil.
Those are both yours.
However, you're only going to get two dice.
Got one
hit. This is gonna be my first hit.
Okay, so that's that. Okay, so we'll sweep tokens. Nobody has any.
Blount.
Set some more maneuvers.
What's he doing? He's doing a 290.
Oh, I was trying to do that way.
I'll let you go this way. You've been putting your dials the wrong way, so
just
keep that in mind.
I've just been thinking.
I know. The way I do it is...
An unhinged astromech.
I'll take my dial.
Who?
And I'll
unhinged
it
just one. All three maneuvers are green? All my
threes
are green.
And then I'll do
only
the dial that
right?
way so that
only
you know it's
threes.
Always the right way.
Yeah. That's what I did.
Yeah,
okay. So and it's whose action.
Dang, I might replace that with my R2 astromech.
It's scum only.
Oh, that's probably why I don't have it then. Yeah.
And then my 9 does a 290.
Yeah, they're not.
And that's why
they're a salvaged astromech, not an astromech. So they
completely different
class. Yep.
Ever so slight.
They're so busted up and broken.
He goes with his 2.
Hmm. Okay, so interesting. I'll focus. This is very interesting.
Yeah. You roll 4 defense dice because I shot you.
I'm not stressed, so now I can actually move my guy.
I'm
not stuck in the green.
Hit from the mango to the face.
4?
Yeah.
If he gets blinded pilots.
Oh, you can still do white maneuvers,
like,
right?
Okay, so
couldn't have K-turned him before. I'm try that. That might actually work.
Three hull
then,
on
the best one I had was my hawk. I shot it with this one gun.
I got to do my 4 dice primary then.
Four dice primary?
Yeah, I wanted to.
Double shot?
It would be cool, but I'd rather kill Dash.
Yeah, before he shoots?
Yeah.
Yeah, but Dad, I also have Lieutenant Blount, who can shoot countess.
Oh no, she loses her non-existent,
she's already been hit once,
yeah,
but
exactly.
She's pretty,
okay.
She's a 32
okay.
point ship, so real cheap.
So I'm going
oh,
to
you,
cheap
oh,
as
you
can make
her up?
I bumped her
oh,
down.
Okay.
No, I did bump her up to a 6.
Oh, okay, so then there is no simultaneous fire.
No. He's actually an 8. He's actually right,
ready?
An 8.
Yep.
So
okay,
that's those
two.
Are the two Slimals.
Yeah.
She's a 6 and he's a 9.
I don't think you can complete that one.
I don't think
okay,
so.
Okay, so 4 dice
on
dash
on.
From
yeah.
quick draw.
I don't think I complete that one.
And oh my yeah. god.
There we go.
That sucks. Hang on, don't
no,
roll your
you
dice.
Don't. No, wait. Sorry. Bomb. You sure?
Damn it.
Yeah, because
I want to keep my focus. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to accuracy
corrector.
Wouldn't
be able to clear the back end here. I'll try anyways.
Okay. Do 2 hits.
That's where my template would be. Oh, no, I'll just leave my
template.
Okay, yeah. So you know what? I'm just not going to bother.
Okay.
Just say a little clear. Yeah. And then you
so,
just push him around.
No, I have initiative.
Yeah,
so that is my
close enough. Good enough for the girls I go
believe
with.
Believe that.
Okay, you're first of the two threes.
Okay, so
I'm going to bring him in closer, I guess. Eh?
Yeah.
4
dice primary.
Forward 2.
No token.
Sort of a slow roll for him.
Well, we got to shed this.
Good agreement.
That is 2 hits and a crit.
2 forward.
2 hits and a crit.
Moving in range on.
Okay.
Yeah.
So 2 hits.
Action. Oh yeah, action.
2.
And he blows
Angel
up.
Pilot. So that was ignored, and then it just goes bam, blam.
Boom.
So.
And now Blount shoots.
Blows up. Okay. And last but not least.
So he has.
So,
what does he have? Archons?
Oh no way! Really?
Oh yeah, he's gone.
Close.
He does not
actually,
have our
oops, sorry. That's fine. It's a bad pick.
Just miss her?
Yeah, I'm quick
it'll
draw.
It'll fly over the asteroid, unfortunately.
You have Archon quick
will
draw.
Fly over the asteroid,
draw,
but I think you might actually
you don't.
Complete that.
No, you don't, dude.
I believe
yeah,
I'll
you gotta follow the line.
See that?
You're
the,
put it
the
on
laser
the
is
yep.
way more
yep.
accurate.
Yep.
You can see that's
so
not,
you're good.
It's not even really that close.
However, you do roll for your damage
you have
now.
Arc on the other two.
Might as well shoot the 9.
There we go.
Okay.
What range?
No,
I
take
a
hit.
That is my last shield. Yeah, no, I was oh, wait, you're not. You can't use that.
There's your
dial, okay, so,
sir.
That looks like. Alright,
bottom of my stack is Contracted Scout, who in this case.
So when I fly over an asteroid, I don't get an action, right?
One hit?
I believe I get an action. I think it's these, I don't get an action.
It's if you land on it.
Okay, I get 2 evade dice.
I don't get
stressed,
right?
As soon as the
fire
hits,
he doesn't take stress, he takes damage. He didn't land on it, so he can still shoot.
He can still shoot.
He
doesn't get an action.
He doesn't get an
action.
Okay.
Yeah, roll damage and no action.
Yep. And
that's already
okay.
good.
So he's going to do a forward one.
So Countess has no shot. We sweep tokens.
Sweep.
I did one.
Yeah,
fits.
Yeah.
Wow, that's
tight.
That
tight,
is
tight.
Wow, why can I get that? Okay,
I
thought
know,
I,
right?
I thought I would have been like that in that situation.
His
here.
Action is going to be to acquire a target lock on the Y-Wing.
Yeah.
Lieutenant
Y-Wing
always hits with his anything.
Yeah, the Y-Wing.
Yeah.
5 hit points.
Got
so many goddamn hit points on your ships.
Yeah.
Alright, so that's the jump master, Asajj Ventress. Doing a bank one.
Yep.
Okay, my turn. Both my guys are going to attack.
Oh, did you dodge it?
Is that? Can
yeah.
you see my nubbins? I can't
yeah.
see my nubbins.
Yeah, you're.
It was actually with
could
one
get,
hit.
Could
one,
he get that
real.
Shot back?
Perfect. Okay.
Why?
Cross ability, right? Lose one shield.
Do not.
Didn't
get
hit. Yeah,
no, that's
not
me.
Yeah.
Could
yeah.
get that shot off.
He could have.
No.
I could have just.
Gonna leave my arc the way it is.
Oh no, I rolled the
bait.
I rolled the bait.
And last but not least, Kavil. Gonna do a turn 3.
But even if I had a focus, and he's got sensor cluster, so it's a guaranteed evade result, regardless of what you're rolling.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
See the guy with accuracy
card?
What
is that? Yep. And then
when defending, you may spend a
focus
token to change one of your blank results to an evade result. So
right,
if I roll the
yep.
an
so
evade,
Kavil
if I roll
is gonna autoblaster turret
or
on your Y-Wing,
a blank,
3 dice
because
it's out of arc.
Token, I can turn it into a blank.
And I'll focus that into 3
awesome.
Unavoidable hits.
2 points, I think.
Where do you get it?
It's a. Those came on the tie set.
Boom, boom.
Those are only on the tie set.
Dad.
Oh, I keep forgetting to use her starter combat. What?
It's something we need to get.
What?
The tie set.
Yeah, I know, obviously. Jesus. Okay. Range two. Three dice.
This is screwy.
Two crits.
I can't avoid those.
Well, you can avoid one.
I can get one, but it doesn't matter.
So he's down. Bam, bam, he's down.
Oh, man, it is unreal.
I lost. I was double I. Lost that on him. He didn't have any target locks on anybody, right? No, that was double Y and double O. Okay, good. Okay, and then I guess last but not least is contracted scout here is going to open up on double Y. Range 3.
I'm going to spend the target lock.
It's too bad I don't have the target. Should have taken it.
It's random.
Should have taken a lock on him.
I'll let you pick one.
Did he actually take an action?
One? Yeah.
Yep.
Just damage cockpit.
Yes.
What is that? No, whatever. No, I don't think he did. I think I forgot to. Whatever. Too late.
Yeah.
Two focus. Nothing. Nothing. Okay. So now you got your Lothal Rebel. And your other guy is no shot because everybody's out. Everybody's too far away.
All right. So he's got a shot.
Cavil or... Cavil's been stripped, and the contracted scout has been stripped. Both have
this is
five hull.
This is a range two shot, so we'll take the range two.
Okay.
We'll go four primary, range two.
Okay.
You want to play after this again? Or?
Sure.
Holy Jesus.
So
two crits and a hit?
Two crits and a hit.
Okay.
Interesting.
Cavil can avoid hopefully one of those, and he doesn't. So two crits and a hit. This could blow him up.
Let's hope it does.
So two crits,
two hits.
First.
Oh,
hit,
two
no, one hit and then two crits, right? Yeah,
it's looking a little bleak for him.
Two hits and a crit.
Yes, that's what
I'll
do.
What? I thought it was two crits, wasn't it?
Two crits. Sorry, you're right. Yeah. Sorry.
I really like
so
that.
So a hit and then damage engine. Turn maneuvers as red now. Damn it. And structural damage. Reduce your agility by one. Spend an action, roll an attack die to repair.
Okay.
All
right. Count it.
Okay. That's so that.
Three
yep.
Straight.
We want to ask them.
So turn it into
a
K turn.
Second, are you recording a second one?
Yes.
Can I
yes.
So three straight. She turns it into a K turn.
All right. So nope. We sweep tokens
right,
and
green maneuver.
He gets
three maneuvers. So
oh, he does on the guy he attacks. So
he's trying to. He's YY. Where's my YY?
Beep.
Oh, do I want to change it the way?
I know.
So
good.
You may acquire.
I love
yeah. Do you want to keep it on him, or do you want to keep it on Cap?
Okay.
Keep
and
it
then
on,
okay. So my eight has initiative. He's actually doing
so
a one bank
as an action.
Three.
Nope.
Oh, as an action.
As an action. If you have the gyroscopic targeting, if you do a 3-4-5 speed maneuver at end of combat, you rotate your arc again.
At the end of combat.
At the end of combat.
That one.
Setting up
oh,
for the next
died.
Round.
Gyroscopic
that ship can do it too.
Gyroscopic targeting.
It's the only other one.
What's that?
Oh, yeah.
I don't have it equipped.
Okay.
Blount. Blount up.
No?
Yeah. He's doing a one okay, so bang.
That guy there.
I can do that for you.
The outrider?
Yeah, the outrider.
I was flying the outrider.
What's
the what?
Mm. Oh. I updated my rail list.
And what's his action?
I got the arc with the stress droid and a tactician.
His action.
So on the front or back,
work.
You can stress people.
Well, the whole tactician. The tactician
then...
wasn't a limited card before.
So you can want to. Like three
can you have multiple target locks?
You cannot, unless you have something that tells
limited,
you can.
Right?
Can you,
yeah. You can put more than one in the list, not per ship.
Oh, okay.
That's what
can
limited
do.
He can
so,
he can reacquire his target lock and put
yeah,
it on somebody else.
Yeah, he's going to reacquire it and throw it on somebody
else. It'll probably work.
Yeah.
I'm thinking about what I'm going to do. For
with this guy? You're going to do
one.
It on this guy?
Yeah.
Okay. And then this guy
really?
Does a three.
I think it's always been like that.
It actually probably was.
Just so you can put like three on the party bus and like do a ride and get three.
Three S turn.
Oh, the outlaw tech?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's limited.
Yeah, so you can't like stack and be like,
I stopped dead and get three focuses.
Yeah, I know, right?
Like, that would have been so dumb.
Do you think they'll ever put a weapon on the recon or no?
Let's see if this makes it.
Oh, that's easy. Easy peasy.
Easy, got it.
You're not close enough to the edge to fall off yet.
You'll find
yeah,
all
right, of
this area.
Two.
This area might be a little bit more expensive because it's label on this rotation. So you stress.
Okay, we got about 25 minutes left, Ray. So
all right,
lots of time for you to finish killing
yeah.
me.
Check
yeah, right.
So many hit points to chew through on those freaking ghosts.
Anywhere from.
No,
so,
no
ghosts. I've never seen this before. I've never faced this before.
No,
so.
Oh, I was so close.
Yeah,
it's
I
hard.
So close on Saturday. I mean Saturday.
Everybody was. Yeah.
No, I don't.
Okay.
His action?
He's going to have to acquire a target lock.
What you doing, buddy?
Let's try this.
Okay. All
right. Well, shoot
him. Let's keep
oh,
let's
he still
playing. Let's keep playing.
So he's going to...
Okay.
He's going to focus.
So... quick draw is the fastest.
And this guy. Ready?
Yep.
Forward 3, I knew he was doing something like that.
Yeah.
And...
Range 2.
So I'll
use my extra
I'm
dice
to.
Off.
I doubt and his action?
So 3 dice against 2 dice. So hang on, let me roll my dice
that
first.
That is YY.
And
I will
accuracy
correct
for
that.
That's currently the target of the double Y.
2 hits. You get 2 dice.
Yeah.
And 2 hits.
Yeah.
2 hits, he's dead.
Okay.
Boom.
Okay.
Good game.
So bottom of my stack.
So
he's going to do an S turn. 2.
When we first started to get Pokemon cards, my boss was like, what are you going to do with all this energy? So I tried to pack it up as well.
And he's actually kind of...
barrel roll.
I think this guy's had too much
to get out of that autoblaster range.
That sucks. While still getting a shot himself. Alright. Ventress.
Oh my goodness.
He's going to do a forward 5.
A Zed Storm.
We're just above that.
Oh yeah, this is definitely well. Have, like, marks but I just build the list to win.
Yeah.
Build
so
it.
So with the new
Errata, he's going to leave the arc the way it is.
The new Errata.
To show that I have 3 advances.
Paul's now 3.
Yeah, that's cool.
Rumble or the Empire.
It actually makes it kind of a
and then last but not least,
actually
Kavil is doing a bank one. Oh, sorry, her action is to take a focus. Kavil is doing a bank one. Which hopefully should get him out of autoblaster range.
It does.
Unfortunately, it totally puts him in range to take a bunch of dice. He'll probably die this round. But that's okay, because he's going to shoot first. So, start a combat. Yep. Ventress applies a stress token to your local rebel. I remember!
It gives you slots. It doesn't force you to use it.
Kavil is going to consume his target lock. To shoot his... Oh, wait, he never actually took his action. His action is to take a focus. There. So now Kavil uses his target lock to shoot his Flechette Torpedo.
Yep.
3.
It's too late to start a drop.
Oh, crap.
Wow, and then I focused that up into 3... two hits and a crit.
So, 2 hits and a crit...
On this guy.
This guy.
Yeah.
That's shield's gone.
And
a crit.
I don't need the space.
Yeah, I should have put a
different direct hit.
Awesome!
I don't know why I was thinking.
Unfortunately, his hull is not, hull value is not 4 or lower, so he doesn't take a stress token.
Yeah. I'm going to barrel roll in.
Next up is Ventress, who is going to...
Yeah, some of
them
have
like on
oh, shit.
Long.
Yeah,
is that what I...
That yeah.
Oh, no, it's
nope.
Not.
Nope.
Oh, thank God.
It's at the end phase, isn't it, when he dishes off his stress?
3 dice.
Yeah.
Two hits.
Two hits.
So what do you got? Four long with Zuckus.
No focus or bait.
Oh,
his four long shield with intelligent agency. So I can see
awesome.
Where you're going.
And then last but not least, the contracted scout gets two dice.
I guess just by red maneuvers.
She got red maneuvers and she has no shed here.
Hit the crit.
Oh, okay.
Nothing. So it's not actually obstructed because close is here. Oh, okay. So but that's fine.
Okay, so I'm going to
hit
use
the crit.
My evasion token.
Oh, to avoid the hit. Or the hit in this case, you take a crit.
Take a crit. So that is against YY. This guy. Yep. Pilot. During planning phase.
Shaken pilot.
Cannot be assigned straight maneuvers.
Okay. Now your guys get to shoot.
Yep.
Cavil's dead.
Okay, so his only target is Cavil, so he's going to take four primary and range two.
He has no dice. Cavil has no dice.
Yep, no dice.
And so Cavil's dead. Three
Cavil
hits.
Cavil goes boom. Yeah, I got a ship down. Yay.
One, two, three. There we go.
Hey, you still don't even get half. You still don't even get half of my ships. I should just fly around and like.
Did Cavil do any damage?
He got his torp off and he did a bunch of autoblast.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Cavil did a lot of work, man. Actually, yeah.
We thought he would.
The only problem with this right now is the Flechette Torpedoes are not allowing me to trigger the stress. Because he's running fucking ghosts! And I have to get their hull four or less.
I thought the Flechette torpedoes were just straight up
four hull at when full.
It has four or lower.
And four has to be added.
The hull value.
Hull value has to be added.
What?
Yeah.
So it's only good against small ships at all.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm rethinking this a lot.
It'll work against Aegis. That's the only one. It'll work against.
Yeah.
Redial.
Yeah. It's not so great against large ships.
No.
The maneuver's already set.
Still does damage, and you can still use your primary. I mean, it's not like. What direction do you it's useless.
Are your asteroids close, or do you only have your...
It's just, it's not as effective as it could have been.
I just don't feel like digging mine all that
well. And I haven't been able to trigger the black market slicer tools at all.
Oh, no. Right there.
Oh, yeah. A little zero hero there.
Freaking zero hero. Oh, no.
I mean, I expected this to do maybe a little better than it did, but...
Yeah, sweet.
This is
pick random three.
First
random three?
Random
use the advance at all, much less all three of them. They're mildly disadvantaged.
So random three.
Weird, because this is the high advance. Why does the high advance... We're all going to die. I'm going to die.
Yeah, I know.
Shouldn't this be a million better faster? Way better die.
No, man. I think you're gonna win.
I don't think so. That autoblaster guy, that little Cavil man.
Oh, did he hurt one of the ghosts?
Oh, he hurt a lot. Right. He was getting three hits.
What's
man.
He down?
He's
to?
Got eight on one and eight on the other still.
That's half. You've dropped them both down to half hits?
That's half. And this is plus nine.
No?
Oh, eight because of the direct.
Well, you've knocked both of them to half. So you get points on both. His list is at half points. No, that's solid. Wow.
It doesn't feel it to me because it's not, I've had this wonderful thing going on with Asajj and she's like, yeah, you just black market slash your tools, you just stay in the back. It doesn't matter.
But she can actually trigger up and then it forces them to do a green maneuver.
There is that. At least I'm getting control over his maneuvers.
That has really slowed me down a lot, actually. I haven't able to do my, like, my coveted 5K.
Oh, so you don't drop your stress on that one?
Nope.
Eh?
I don't.
Ooh. Yeah, I was blocking his 5. You got it. Right there.
I'm good to go.
Right there. There you go.
Boop.
There
you go.
Good to go.
Nope, I just wanted to put a little bit of distance in.
I'm 100 even roll.
You cheaters. What are your pass
skills? Well, zero. I've got a 5 with adaptability. Okay. I've got a 9 straight up, and a 7 with adaptability.
Hi.
3 dice.
Okay. And I'm 1-1-3-8-6.
So he's going
so
to.
So there could be conflict with the 6.
The target lock.
Oh yeah.
Or the 8.
Or the 8.
Just out.
That's
yes.
Awesome.
And in.
Okay. And now I can take the shot.
Oh, I already have a target lock on him, though. I already have a target lock on him.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You're already double. You're already target locked on
him. Unless you
so your action should probably be in focus.
First.
Your choice. Focus or an evade. At this point, I don't think anybody's going to get close enough to do a whole lot of damage, so either one is going to be worth it.
I'll take a focus.
Okay, awesome. So now we move on to Contracted Scout, who does a turn two. I know that's through the debris, but that should clear the debris afterwards, I think. So I'm just clearing it. So I do get a stress. I do not take an action.
And you roll to see if you get a crit.
Oh yes, that's right. Here we go.
Nothing. I have a lot of focuses. I turned that into a.
Ventress is going to do a turn three. I honestly was expecting you one of your cats over here a bit, so
I was kind of stupid.
She will take a focus.
Yeah.
All right. So top of the stack. I got no shot with Ventress. I don't think anybody's in range there. Not too far away.
So you get to shoot whoever with your.
I do. They're both equally hurt.
Both equally hurt. Yep. You're right.
So two dice against that guy, because that guy, I don't know, closest would be.
Still no obstruction, so.
Not obstructed, because I think it's that side of the rock.
Yeah, that'll be this
so.
Side of the rock. So
but I'm going to shoot this guy. All right.
Maybe they're trying to keep them all clustered.
Range 2? Was it range 3?
Range 2.
Okay, so let's see.
Range 2.
You're going to spend your turn.
So, no tokens, nothing. This is over now.
Okay, so I'm going to take a 4 primary into your contract of skill.
Yes. Yes, you do, and it's range 2. Is it?
Okay.
No, it's 3.
Okay.
Close to close, oh, it's still going to be 3.
I still have one more.
Yes, you're right.
That is still 3. Yes. Okay.
Dang it.
And I got to shoot you first, so.
One hit?
He's spending his turn. Oh, that's for sure.
Oh, there you go. That's right. Double Y.
Let's re-roll that.
Wait. No. He's got a target lock on him.
What does he have? He has track.
Because that's double Y. That's double O.
Yeah. He has track to beam because of the title.
So, and these are all blanks.
Yep.
So one hit. I don't even get to change my focus over. Wow.
There you go. One of these.
Wow. What a huge opportunity miss here.
Wow, honestly, I expected you to tear the ever-living bejeebers out of me, and this is turning out way better than I expected.
Oh, your piloting skills here right now are really massive, really showing its class here.
Well, I've flown the Y-Wing with the Unhinged a lot.
Yeah.
And I'm getting much better with the Contracted Scout. Ventress is easy, you just do a green 3, and away you go.
There we go. Okay, 5.
So that's that. Well, sweet tokens.
Yeah. I'm derping my piloting skills. This is a battle of piloting skills, and you are winning it, my sir.
I'm just, I'm thinking really, really hard about my maneuvers right now. So.
He's got a missile.
Yeah.
So we're gonna move for expansion.
Double defense.
So.
Oh God, that's there.
I'm gonna adaptability down.
Yeah, let's do that. No, no, no. Let's not do that. That's stupid. Let's do that.
Makes no sense for me to be a 6.
And then
not without
you
initial.
Are going to.
So, Alza or Alza required a start of rock.
Yeah,
that one. There. Honestly, this has felt like a tough uphill battle for me.
Yeah, there's
so many hit points to chew through on those freaking ghosts.
Yeah.
I missed a lot of golden opportunities too. I missed.
Yeah,
really missed
honestly,
that.
Yes, I think you need to fly this list a few more times to get a better feel.
Yeah.
A couple of derps that we both made early in the game.
Hey, Glenn. It's got potential. It does. What do you want to record against?
Don't care.
You want to play the Super Warhawk?
Super Warhawk?
That's what I'm calling my boosting evading Mega Hawk.
What?
You wanna see?
Yeah, okay, we'll try it out. Oh, that's so nice.
It's boosting
evading
jukes with TLT.
Okay, you ready?
No.
Oh, you're the guy. Okay.
Yeah, this.
He's got ID, so he shares his seat.
I did that exact same build just today. I'm like, I'll put ID on Autoblaster Turret with boost.
Clear that stress.
And then engine upgrade.
You boost, get the evade, and then you TLT with Juke.
Oh, you're TLTing with Juke. Okay,
yeah.
I didn't do Juke.
That
I just did
group.
And
it's like a totally open group. Yeah.
And then
Scum only.
Scum. Oh, okay, so you got
and
he's got shares
eight.
The
is that
whatever
eight
ship
or
he's
an
on
actual
the ability of the aggressor.
Eight was horn tag.
Oh, sweet. So you can like
and when he has a boost, he can get an evade.
I will adopt ability.
I have one where he used
the
I know.
I know. I was just pushing him a bit, and I was like, "Oh wait a second!" No, but that did overlap, didn't
it? Yep, it did.
Okay.
And then
no action and no damage.
Ariel.
You'll be able to put him on in a second. This guy's going to do a forward two.
This actually
shed his stress.
I didn't notice till the next
so
day.
So it's a bad
I came
day.
Back and it was still on the ground. I was stoked that the piece was there.
So he sheds his stress and is like, oh my god. You got to get the hell out of Ark.
Nice,
which probably not. Oh well.
I like the look of your list, Michael. It's just kind of
and then
Z-Sworn.
I'm gonna do a sharp turn two there with Ventress.
You got like your there's your awesome ship. Who's like, I just wanted to bring a few friends. You know, I'm gonna say you're just hanging out.
And her action
like,
is
yeah,
going
we'll
to be
it.
To
we don't have names,
shift it,
actually.
Shift her mobile art to match her primary art in the front.
Paid extras.
I was told
they're like 60 Batman.
Yeah.
The
like
start of combat.
Some guy gave me 60 bucks to
I will assign a stress token to that ship.
And then, what is that? Sarasu?
Yeah, Sarasu. Yeah.
Okay.
So
everybody, all you guys shoot.
Let's go do something.
So three dice.
You should be able to beat me up here.
Okay.
Three dice. Yeah. Three dice. Okay.
How about these goons? Yeah.
Pinch two. And then I get nothing. Oh, man. Ventress is sucking that. Okay. And then. Three dice from this guy.
Some things, like, I know it's like a lot of
arguing
shit.
Oh, yeah,
nice,
yeah,
two
hits. Like, so iconic to Star Wars that it's like, but the X-Men was fair, supposed to be like fairly new.
Alright, so I get the fire back.
In A New Hope. And the Y-Wing was the workhorse of the Rebels. And the X-Men is based off the Zed. Why is there no Zed in Rogue One?
Oh, I should.
You see them in the background.
You want to borrow some?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So,
seven.
Because Rogue One is all about ground combat, so you see like their transport.
And then 58.
Oh, 57.
Oh,
because
yeah.
Oh, there's only one that's a possible.
You got an Autoblaster on him.
I got five primary as well.
Or you got five primary.
I'm gonna take five primary.
Yeah, I would.
Okay.
Three hits. That's. I keep forgetting to change his target lock. I've hit him like three times now, and I get an automatic target lock change, and I've always forgotten to take it.
Atmospheric conditions. Like, so the regular tie already had mods for atmospheric flying.
Here we go.
Nothing.
Three hits. Who?
Because that could have killed him.
He ain't dead yet, but he's pretty close.
That should have killed him. I should have been able to
kill him. Three.
Dang it.
Five.
That's you could have one-shot him, but.
Yeah, that was my mistake.
Didn't
keep
work out. Okay.
We're going to switch that target lock now.
What's the timer say?
We're going to switch that target lock onto him.
Oh, yeah.
Where did that go?
Oh, there's your double up.
What's the timer? Says 8 minutes.
8 minutes. Okay, we probably got two more rounds left. So.
Yep. And he's got no shot.
Nope.
So we're good.
I don't really know.
So I've got 8. So you're 6 close.
Oh, and before I reveal, I'm going to learn their Star Wars now. I was like, wait, you know, these ships are right here?
Yeah.
Now the TIE Fighter still exists 30 years later when you've already seen the TIE Interceptor in the movies. You've seen E-Wings. Why is the X-Men still there? And, the upgrade to the G7.
Actually, the Alliance, or sorry, the Resistance uses the T-70. It's actually an old ship.
Okay, and
the
eight.
Republic uses a T-85.
Or actually, no, he's a he's an eight. So you're
yeah. You just never see it because it's not about the New Republic anymore.
So,
is
that stick thing in effect now?
Which?
Yeah.
The site? Yes. Yeah.
I am so.
I know, right?
Yeah.
Like now
okay.
this list is gonna change to have Sarasu like freaking crazy.
But he opened that bottle and got two conquerors.
This is officially a PLM table. Big chefs. They got suits, so easy to see what's going on here.
I think I might eke out a win here because I got half points on both his ghosts.
Yep.
Unless
I
burn
down,
I
got both.
We're down to two. We're down to about two turns left.
I keep forgetting to change my target lock to this guy. I've shot him like three times, and that would have killed him. Because I've just been like,
you could have re-rolled those two.
Re-roll them all the time, right?
That's like probably like 12 dice I missed re-rolling. So he should have been long dead. That's just my newbiness to kidding.
Well, how many times have you flown this list?
Did it include the backgrounds for that?
I still have to look for them.
Nah.
Yeah, you get I think they come with the ships.
I think I threw out the prototype ones.
I threw a bunch out, and then I was like, they go in the thing.
Well, I knew that's what they were for, but when I first bought my prototype, I was like, things are stupid.
All right, so I'm dialed in.
And then when I got it, just on a whim, like, whatever, I got a couple extra bucks in my pocket, I'm going to buy some.
And you regret it.
These are actually really, it's still shitty that they're expensive and you got to pay the extra, but they are really nice.
They are really nice.
Seeing all your bits, and now, so I bought a couple more Vancouver's, and I got like 9 ships with them now.
She has a range
of prototype because I love using Valen. So Valen needs one because he's going to show up on the table a lot for me. But now I don't have the piece.
Yeah.
And I think I even my Special Forces one, so I didn't even got rid of it. The ones in the Special Forces.
Yeah, don't think he's going to make a bump.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, there's some nice synergies with Valen getting his target locks there.
Oh, hold on, your nubbins in front. Yeah. There you go. Now your nubbins in front of
my nubbins are both on the back here.
Okay, and so there you go. And there you go.
Sort of half hoping I would clear him a bit.
Okay, this poor jump master, he's so dead. He's gonna do an S turn 2.
Yeah, well, my ghost is dead too here, so.
And because he's about to die, he's going to acquire a target lock on that guy and try to get his ordinance off. Okay. And then last but not least, Asajj Ventress doing a turn 3. Getting the hell out of Dodge. Getting the hell out of Doge. Boop. As an action, she will rotate the arc there. Did he execute a green?
Nope.
No, he didn't.
He did not.
So he keeps his stress.
He does.
Yep. Awesome.
I want to try. I thought I might be able to sneak in between those two ships.
I will.
And not bump, but.
I will. Experimental interface. Which gives me a stress. To use my black market slicer tools, I take one attack die.
How do you mean?
On a hit or a crit, I remove your stress, and you take a face down damage card to your health.
Sure.
No, I'm talking about.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry, those are mine.
One's with that.
Yeah, never mind.
Oh, okay.
So,
yeah,
I don't actually remove your stress. Okay, at the start of combat, I add a stack another stress on there.
Sure.
Yeah, and then I'll leave.
Okay. So Ventress is gonna roll 3 dice at this guy. Okay, double up.
Okay, you won.
2 hits.
2 hits.
Range 2.
You got new foil.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 damage. Okay, and then he's going to.
No, he's coming in on shoot table.
Yes, okay, good. So he's going to consume his target lock to shoot his Flechette Torpedo.
Yep.
3 dice. One of these turns into a hit with my guidance chips, so 2 crits and a hit. He's not dead yet, is he?
Nope.
Oh, damn it!
Now they don't have any ordnance on the Zeus, do they?
No, okay.
They're just straight. That's how I was able to
get 5. So range 2 on him.
Okay, my 4.
Yep.
Got a 3 bank.
4 dice.
So he's going to spend his target lock. Smart guy this time.
Yeah, this time.
Wow.
A double O, there you go.
And she will put a free evade, and she'll take
what?
Way!
1 crit, that could be enough.
Well, all I needed was like a focus, man, and I would have had him.
And I get an evade. Oh my god, he survives a little longer.
Window, man. Now I'm gonna throw my dice out the window.
No.
So he gets
to shoot. 6. Oh, he can reacquire his target lock. There you go. And then he gets a range 3 unobstructed.
Is it 3?
Yep. No matter how close you get, it's gonna be 3. Yep. Yep. But it is unobstructed, and you can, as long as you get 2 good hits.
And he already has a target lock. So I'm going to. Oh, he just did a normal maneuver. He's got a focus there as well.
Where's his focus?
He's supposed to have given it to him.
Okay. I'll give it to you.
Expecting four long to get in there.
So nothing there, so we'll just focus that up.
Three hits.
Okay, so that's going to cause
I'm
a bump.
I'm going to get three dice. I get one evade. He takes two. That's
two
dead. One, two. And my jump master's dead. How much time we got left on the timer?
2 minutes.
Okay, last round then.
Last round.
Okay. Woo boy! Woo! Okay.
This guy should just.
Okay, I'm good.
All right, do it to it, my friend.
Four straight, just white maneuver. Don't matter, just get out of this last. Just try to get out of like combat range.
Nice, nice.
Take your stress with you.
Yep. He's this dude.
He's gonna be hurt.
Three. He's coming into the fight.
Okay.
Combat.
Oh, you were really concentrating on Kavil and my scout there, right?
Yeah.
That's good, because I want to put them in harm's way.
Well, also, it's target of opportunity, right?
Well, exactly. I tried to keep Ventress out, way out.
Yeah, it was targets of opportunity. I had no choice. Okay. And I had to split my
action.
Oh, yeah.
Let's guess, I guess.
He's going to attempt the target lock.
I'll do your black sun.
Nope. Focus. Okay. Ventress is going to attempt to turn three.
Hopefully I don't end up too close against the board there.
Oh boy.
You're good.
Ooh, you're good. I'm going to rotate my arc.
$2.
Not that it matters, because I don't think we have range.
Okay. So my
top of the stack. No shots.
So this 8, I'm going to fire first.
Yeah.
I'm going to fire
okay.
Yeah.
So is that it?
3 dice.
Okay.
What time we got left?
27 seconds.
Let's call it.
Oh, yeah?
Let's call it.
All right.
Good game, sir.
Good game.
Good game. So you got.
So let's see what the points are.
Really?
No, right? Holy cripes. All
right.
Hey, this is going to be a dice
I think you still won.
Game. I can feel it.
Pretty sure you still won.
I can feel it.
I might have, but I don't know.
Oh, you got it? Okay. Never mind.
Cards in here.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you took
my
Kavil was 29. I just wanted to move a bunch of them. And the contracted scout was 27. So you got 56.
So
you're right.
Is that all they're worth?
Yep. 29 and 27 respectively. Ventress was 44.
We'll do your black sun.
Black sun?
My Merle's coming in.
4 dice.
Wow.
I think so.
Wow,
like
she's 54?
44?
Yeah,
that's oh, you're gonna win.
With
the
soul I scored was 56 there, right?
Yep.
So
you
scored 56. So
and
add 21 for the gold wing.
Okay.
And add
here's one.
20
okay.
For the half for the this guy. And
19. My other 8 didn't fire.
Oh,
20
right.
And 19.
So do him first.
He's gonna do Flechette cannon into that guy.
60.
Okay.
60.
I beat
point.
You by 3 freaking points.
Yeah, 3
holy
points.
Good freaking game. So hard to kill
another,
those freaking
ghosts.
If there
was another
wow.
Like 10 minutes,
yeah.
It'd be a lot
that was that was a good game. So what was your
one
takeaway from this
yeah,
then, right?
All
right,
so my takeaway
yeah.
Is I really need to
well,
focus on my piloting skills. My piloting skills were absolutely
yes,
atrocious.
Yes.
And I gotta remember. I just
so
always forget. Like I forgot
shield.
A lot of.
Yeah. I forgot Ventress a couple
down.
Times.
I
so.
Forgot to change my target lock. I don't know how many times that would have.
Yeah.
That would have changed the face of this battle. Like unbelievable.
Let's go against
yeah.
The Black Sun again.
And also, I also kept
focus.
Forgetting all through the fight. Chopper actions while stressed.
Oh my God!
And
Zeb
when I was he was bumped. When he was bumped, I could still shoot.
Well, that's why I tried to bump the other guy instead of the one with Zeb.
But Zeb got bumped a couple times.
Yep.
I still could have shot 5 in the face.
Oh, you could have. Although the one time that the one time with the bump there, you were actually overlapping the rock as
well.
Well,
oh yeah, that. Well, that's true too. That
yeah.
One. But still,
right.
I mean,
oh,
even
yeah, like that. Okay.
Like I really did not.
Comes down to remembering what cards.
Remembering what
cards
you're using. Like I really didn't even like fly this half as good as I could have or should have.
Yeah.
And chopper actions while stressed. Like well, that was.
Damn it.
That really slowed me down because then I couldn't take a target lock. I couldn't change target lock. I couldn't take a focus.
Yeah. No, I hear you. My takeaway on this, I would say, is that the Flechette Torpedoes are interesting in that I can use them to stack, stack stress, but they're only going to be good on hull points.
Okay.
Small ships, basically.
Yep.
Small ships.
Now the Countess.
And even then, it's not gonna, that wouldn't work against a Y-Wing.
Yeah.
So there is that. There is that. The only thing that really saved me here was Kavil doing a whole ton of work.
Yeah, he got a lot of three. He got a lot of three pointers, man.
He did. He did. That's exactly what he's there for. So. All right. Well, good game, sir.
Good games, man.
Welcome to the after game report, everybody. That was crazy. Took it to time. So
you know
many hit
no,
points.
That's
on
why I built it. Okay, if you know, I mean, a better pilot other than myself would have done a lot better different.
Well,
and like I said, you know, we both forgot a lot of things.
Yep.
And but the criticalness too is like
Zeb, you could have torn me up with Zeb.
Yeah, when we were like face to face, I could have just hit you five in the face and not even
forgot
all about
I feel
that.
Like you should have won.
Yeah, and Chopper, like I mean actions while stressed, I mean when I was undamaged at the time, I mean I could have just kept putting the pressure, kept taking focus. Like you see, the one time I rolled like three eyeballs. If I would have taken a focus as my stressed action,
that would have been a significant difference. You would have cleared my ships faster.
Absolutely, that makes a real significant difference. Knowing your list and like I mathematically built this, then you have to remember what you build.
It's obvious. It's been a while since you've flown it though, hasn't it?
I've flown it this weekend. To be honest, I wish I don't want to make excuses. I did fly it this weekend.
I'm trying to give you something.
I know you're trying to give me a.
Like trying to give me an out here. Yeah.
And I went to the finals in the tournament at Everything Games with it. And,
nice.
You know,
oh, yeah, this is the one you took to the tournament.
Yeah,
nice.
yeah. I only lost once in the finals. Wow, and again, I just got goaded into coming to Asteroids.
Yeah.
And again, I flew in the middle of Asteroids and I got stuck a little bit. And I got to remember, big ships, don't go near Asteroids.
No, big ships plus Asteroids, bad days.
Bad days.
So there you have it, folks. My first flight of the Shadowcaster. I think it did a great job. It could have done a little better. I did a pretty good job, I think, when I remembered to put those stress down to sort of control his maneuvers there a bit. Wouldn't have affected him so much with the Lothal Rebel there with Chopper because he still would have got his actions in if he'd have remembered. So thanks again for joining us, folks, and we will have our next match sometime after this.
Camera stress, that's what I blame it on.
That camera stress, yeah.
Okay.